my life. I used to wonder if you saw what I was giving you, without ever asking myself if you was willing to. So now that I've given up, I'm feeling wistful. You tell me all you wanted to hear, instead I miss you. A friend of mine once wrote a poem on vicissitudes, looking judged on the one thing that you didn't do. In the face of those you did, it should pale. But humans expect the best, and when you are, you can't fail. Open ocean, you are free to set sails. If you lack the faith to ever see beyond the veil. How long have we lived in a world of dreams without ever poking one another so we know that it's real? What about the journeys that we couldn't undertake? Because whenever I was ready to, you run away. There's no such thing as bad timing, just a wreck left behind when we have failed to read the signage. Some people we shouldn't want, but we warned them. Saw cycles they couldn't break and try to reform them. They're proudly asking themselves, what do we want from them? But they'll go crazy if we ever cease to want them. Hoping for a chance that may never come, imprisoned by a moment long past till at long last. Memories are ultimately compartmentalized, but when it's quiet, we couldn't help but fantasize.
This is what the scanner actually looks like. And in fact, we found in all of our studies activity in a tiny little factory near the base of the brain called the ventral tegmental area. And this is a brain region that actually makes dopamine, a natural stimulant, and sprays it to many brain regions that gives you the elation, the focus, the energy, the possessiveness, the motivation, and the craving for another human being.
Tempted by lust, tempted by trust between me, you, and her. Nothing's ever enough. We want more, so we go for exile the pleasure. Ran through a box of three in a day and bought the next one. She's found that race down in Margaret's, passing J's. Feeling on women who fell first. Humps me in confined space. My version of wet work. She knelt before the sword, trying to fall into it. Closed the door, didn't want all the viewing. Eyes met, time froze. There was more to it. We went back to a place, put on some soft music. I didn't tear the wall down, at least I roared through it. Get a kick from pissing neighbors off, putting strings on best springs, or dents in the wallpaper from headboards. It's more than just lust, it's a self-control freak losing himself willingly to the rush. It's the smell afterwards, goosebumps from the touch. No such thing is too much. Funny thing is, we still treat each other just like friends. What the fuck do we know about love? Show a person that you care for, how you truly feel, that you will be there for. Recently read a story about a young girl that took her own life cause she felt she was a burden to her mother that she felt didn't love her. So much pain, depression made her alive. Then the drugs became a way to escape the torment. Only temporarily though, cause when the high dies, it's back to low. She wrote a note on Tumblr, said it was the end. While a tune and a memory played, I couldn't hold it in. Reminded of the lost ones who had nobody near when the storm would come. I wrote a message to a woman I cherish, asked for forgiveness, cause I never let her know she was very missed. I asked her to never let us lose us. There is still hope for us in the future. Told her she inspired my songs. She replied she believes in me to always be strong and make my way in this life. To be love and give it. One day we'll see each other again, whoever visits.